Hey everybody, here we are again. I was going to brew a Russian Imperial Stout out of the latest beer pouring I've got. Unfortunately, it appears, apart from pale malt and chocolate malt, I haven't really got any of the ingredients. So, it's going to be, I don't know, Lancashire Colonial Stout, perhaps. Right, what have we got? So, we've got 3.2 kilos of pale malt. I've had to lower this down. I used to use 3.5 kilos and it'd be coming out at about 4-4.5%. The last few batches I've been using 3.5 kilos, it's been coming out at 5% or slightly more. All I can think of, perhaps it's the new sparge oil that I made. Better efficiency perhaps, I don't know. Anyway, so 3.2 kilos of pale malt. In the jug, we've got 150 grams of chocolate malt and 100 grams of amber malt. The hops are still in the bags. I'm going to do 60 grams of target at the start of the boil and 60 grams of Styrian in the last 20 minutes. Whirlflock tablet, half a whirlflock tablet at 15 minutes. So, to hot liquor tanks up at temperature, we're going to start mashing in. Just coming up to the hot rate, we're at 102 degrees, and I think it's just about to boil. So I've got my hand on the power switch, 102.5 now. There we just go in. I've never done a stout before. Don't know why. And we're going to have to power off there, I think. Right, we're up at 104. Power back on. Power off. Yeah, I'm not sure if the stout's going to be more difficult to go through the hot break with it being darker, a lot darker. Power back on. You'll soon see. Better stop yapping. Power off. Power back on.
I'll back off. Seems to be much the same as any other beer that I've made. Power back on. Certainly so far. Took me off it for a minute or two. No, I'm going to say that's the hot break. So we've got 60 grams of target going in. It's whole leaf, but it's compressed. That's how I bought it. Bollock shot. Those who like that sort of thing. Thai green curry, very nice. Target hops, even better. Trying to break that block up a bit. Just thought I'd show you this. This is most of the remainder on the hob. I've not filmed this one before, but it goes through the hot break a lot quicker. I don't know if that's because it comes up to temperature a lot faster. It's up at temperature now. But I tend not to have to turn the power off. It just whacks straight through the hot break. Up there, 103. On that, it's pretty much whaling. Didn't have to turn power off or anything. So, there you go. Hot break on the hob. 20 minutes to go. 62 grams of Styrian going in. So we'll come back in 5 minutes. Damn well. 15 minutes to go, whirlflock going in. End of the boil. Just turn the tap on. Turn that ball right down. Turn the power off. Down the drain. And I did realise I reduced the flow rate, so I'm going to need to run through once. I put that back in.
train line with no stops. Should I sit back and just take it, or should I call the shots? Don't listen to them, 'cause you will forget.